never won. And I have a family from Canada visiting me this week. They're from Saskatchewan. Anybody been to Saskatchewan? The Bob North Dakota, Montana, very fertile, rich soil, wheat, barley, flax. But anyway, every day they wake up and they say to me, this place is heaven. Maybe we're in heaven. Maybe it's true. Maybe at least it's a little taste of heaven. So let's talk about heaven this morning. Some years ago, I had a funeral mass, and a person, she was 103 years old. And what I was very impressed about was usually at that age, your relatives or contemporaries or friends are preceding you, and there was a large crowd at the mass. And then at the cemetery, and I couldn't believe how many people were her friends. And so at the end I said, well, when I die at 103, I hope I'll have a crowd like this at the cemetery. And then one fellow answered and said, Father, they'll all be there for you. They'll all be there for you. Well, see, within us there's this instinct, what we call, put there by the manufacturer, that we want to live. We want to live. Not only a good life here, but we want to live. We want to live forever. We don't want to just go out of existence. I don't know how the secular mentality can do it. If you really think that when the body dies, we just go into oblivion and destroy the room. What's the purpose? I don't know. But when we have the assurance of faith that we do live forever, what a difference that it makes. But down through the ages, this has been an instinct. The Chinese Emperor Qin built the Great Wall of China, a very powerful name. And in fact, the Great Wall of China, the astronauts can see it as they circle the Earth. With the naked eye, they can see it. It's that large. But as he got older, he didn't want to die. And one of his court musicians told him there was an island in the Eastern Sea where they had discovered the eternal life. And so Qin sent a fleet of ships looking for this island. It's in the instinct, wanting to live. And then soon after Christopher Columbus came here from Spain, another Spaniard, Ponce de Leon. You know what he came looking for? He came looking for, in the New World now, the fountain of youth. Really thinking that there was a fountain of youth someplace in the Americas. Setting sail. So I hope I make that point. But all of us, every human being, we want more. We want more. And St. Augustine coined some very poignant phrases, but he basically told us that this world cannot fulfill us. You have made us for yourself, O Lord, and our hearts are restless until they rest in thee. We're always restless in this world, incomplete, and only heaven, only life with God forever can fulfill us. You've made us for yourself, and restless until we rest in thee. Well, I want to tell you something. This is the fountain of youth. Right here. This is the fountain of youth. Right from the gospel. Jesus says, I am the living bread come down from heaven. You realize the Eucharist is the heavenly banquet, where heaven and earth are united. There is no separation. The Eucharist is the bread come down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. This is the fountain of youth. Augustine also tells us something. You know, normally when we eat food, fool becomes us. In fact, the Christians will say, you are what you eat. God is healthy. St. Augustine proves that alone. St. Augustine says, you are consumed by what you consume. You are consumed by what you consume. In other words, when we eat the bread of life, the risen Christ, we become the risen Christ. We become, what St. Paul would say, the body of Christ. All of us together are sharing in the life of the risen Christ. We are consumed by what we consume. And truly, we genuflect, we bow to the Eucharist in the tabernacle, but after everybody receives the Eucharist, when you come up and receive, I really should bow to you because you have the risen Christ within you, and you're sharing in his very life. That's what the fountain of Eucharist is, folks, that we share in the life of the risen Christ right now and forever. It doesn't end. We're sharing the very life of God. Yes, the body has to die. We all have to die physically. Christ had to go through that in a terrible way. But we're going to say the creed. And the creed is going to say, we believe in the resurrection of the body. In other words, after physical death, we're not just a spirit or a soul floating around. We are going to receive a risen body, just like Jesus Christ. See, Paul says he has a spiritual body. That's what we're going to get. We will be fully human. We will be like the risen Christ. You know, we have Eucharistic ministers who bring the bread of life to people in the hospital, in nursing homes, and people in their homes. Now, I know Jay and Brenda Neal are here every Monday. They go to this part of the parish bringing the bread of life. And often I'll say, well, thank you. Thank you, Jay and Brenda, for what you do every week. And for all those things that you ask and say, we get more out of it than we do. We get more out of it by bringing the bread of life to fellow Christians. See, that's the point. It is the fountain of youth. That we consume this bread, we're sharing the life of Christ right now. And I keep saying, heaven has begun. Once you get that, heaven has begun. One final thought. Own opinion, but we totally disagree. I really believe that when a person understands and believes and accepts that they're sharing in the life of Christ and that they're going to live forever, it should show on their face. It should show on their face. I point out the Blessed Mother Teresa, even as an older woman, she didn't grow up young, but she was radiant. It showed. And I think if you look at Pope Francis, and you see Pope Francis, 78, 79 years old, breathing with one lung, but there's something radiant about him. There's something joyful about him. That I think is just understanding, realization, a conscious awareness that we're sharing in the very life of Christ right now. It's got to show in our faces. It really does. And that's the good news, folks. We're living forever in Christ.